A very good morning to all of you. I am the faculty from the School of Finance going to conduct another session on business statistics. So let's begin with it. Now, in order to continue with business statistics, there are some prerequisites. So the prerequisite is that one should have a knowledge or a understanding about basic statistics. Then only this session will be really helpful for the students. Now, there are some objectives which we are going to cover through this session. Firstly, we'll discuss on the measure of central tendency. We also discuss on the types of central tendency. Further, discussion will be on the arithmetic mean, which is one of the type of central tendency. Further, median, another type of the central tendency. And there will be discussion on the mode as well. And lastly, there are some references which will be given. What is a measure of central tendency? So first need to see what is central tendency. Central tendency is a descriptive summary of data set through a single value that reflects the center of the data distribution. So let's say I have 100 individuals in a class. So in the 100 individuals, how many males are there, how many females are there, I only can describe it with the percentage or with the mean value of that 100 individual, I can express that. So this is how the measure of central tendency. Now, in other terms, a measure of central tendency is a summary statistic that represents the center point or typical value of the data set. These measures indicate where most value in a distribution fall and are also referred as central location of the distribution. And also, the measure of central tendency is a single value that attempt to describe a set of data by identifying the central position that the set of data is being having. There are various types of central tendency, and as per the types, first type is the mean, second type is the median, and the third category is the mode. So we'll discuss the types of central tendency one by one along with the help of exam. Let's take it further. The very first one type of central tendency is arithmetic mean. Now, the arithmetic mean, it is actually also referred as a mean, is the most common measure of central tendency. And how do we calculate the arithmetic mean? So, usually the arithmetic mean is being represented by x bar. It is being represented by the x bar and equals to the number of value of observed values by the sample size. The sample size is the number of observation. So x1, x2 plus by plus xn is representing as observed values, whereas n is number of values. So this is the formula which is being used for calculating the arithmetic mean. So let's understand it further with the help of example. Now, other feature which the arithmetic mean is being having, the most common measure of central tendency is mean. And how do we refer it? The sum of values divided by number of values. Now, one most important thing about the arithmetic mean is it always get affected by extreme values, which we also refers as outliers. So outliers are basically an extreme value in the data set. Now let's see the example here. Let's say there are values are being given. So for the value is being 1, 2, 3, 4 and the 5. If I calculate the mean of given 5 values, it will be 3. And how do we calculate it? Just I simply do the addition in the observed value divided by the sample size. So here 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus 5 divided by 5, which is a sample size. So exactly I'll get the 15 by 5 equals to 3, which is a mean. So mean also being referred as an average of the value. So this is a normal example, whereas you can very well see in another example the observed value is 1, 2, 3, 4 and 10. 10 seems to be a some different figure because it can be referred as an outlier because it is totally different figure and it is on very high side. And if I calculate the mean for these particular observation would be 4. So So here 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus 10 divided by sample size, which is 5, equals to 20 by 5 equals to 4. So the mean is actually getting changed so drastically just because of the presence of the outlier. So we always keep that in mind. If there are outliers, we always have to remove the outlier, then only we'll be calculating the mean, because the outlier is going to impact the average or the mean value of the data set. Now, next we have the median. Median is what? In an ordered array, the median is the middle number. So the middle value in the given data set, we always refer as a median. 50% above and 50% below. So examples are also being given here. Now the observed values are 1, 2, 3, 4 and the 5. So if I talk about the median, so the median would be here is 3, because 50% is 1 and 2 and the 4 and 5 is again a 50%. So middle value is 3. Now in the second situation, where the outlier is already being presented, the observed values are 1, 2, 3, 4 and 10. So no matter, in while calculating the median, even if the outlier is being presented, is being there in the calculation. And what is outlier? Outlier is basically an extreme value. So median never get impacted by the presence of outlier in the data set. So our median will never get changed. So even in the second situation, median is again the same, because 3 is again the middle value after the 1 and 2 and before the 4 and 10. So the outliers never impact the median, whereas the outlier do impact the mean. Now the next is, how do we find the median location? So for that sake, we have the formula available. The location of the median, basically the median position, and the formula for that is n plus 1 by 2. It actually determines the position in the ordered data. So sometimes it do happen that you have the number of observed values are in even order, or sometimes it is in the odd way. So till the time it is in the odd way, it is very much easy to locate the median. But when it comes to the even values, then it would be difficult to locate the median. So for that sake, we have the formula which need to be applied, and thereby the median position will be allocated on. Now also being stated that if the number of values is odd, the median is the median number. If the number of values is even, the median is average of two middle numbers. So note that n plus 1 by 2 is not the value of the median, only the position, the median in the ranked data. So what it is actually giving, it is not giving the value, it is actually giving the median position, where the median is actually being lying. So let's look further. Further we have the mode. Now, as long as the mode is being concerned, a mode is one of the measures of the central tendency, and the values that occur most often means the value which is having the most maximum iteration in the data set, that will be referred as a mode. Now also turn that modes are not affected by the extreme values. Extreme values means the outliers. So median and mode never get impacted by the outlier, but yes, the mean get impacted by the outliers while its calculation. Now also mention that used for either numerical or categorical data. So whether the data is numerical or the data is non-numerical, on both the data type, the mode can be applied on. So on these categories of data, the mode is the best to calculate. Now, even in a given data set, there could be the possibility that there may be mode, there may be no mode. So depending upon the data set. If the iteration of the data set, any value of the data set is not there, then could be the possibility there is no mode. And also there could be the possibility there may be the several modes as well in the data set. So let's understand it by the help of example. So the observations are given to us starting from 1 till 14. So we can easily see the 1 is having one iteration, 2 is not existing, 3 is one iteration, 5 having the two iteration, the 7 having the one iteration, 8 have no value, 9 is having three iteration, 10 one iteration, 12, two iteration, and 13 repeating once, and 14 repeating once. So we can easily find in this given data set, the mode is 9. Why the mode is being 9? Because the 9 number is being repeating thrice. So the value which has been maximum iteration, the observed value which have maximum iteration, that will be referred as a mode. Now in another situation, where all the observed value as in 0, 1, 2, 3, 5 and 6 are appearing just once. There is no iteration is being available. So as long as this data set is being concerned, there will be no mode is being available in this particular data set. Now we'll discuss on advantages and disadvantages of the different measure of central tendency. So in this, the mean, the median and the mode all are valid measure of central tendency, which we have just discussed in previous slides. Some measure of central tendency become more prominent to use while others are not, and all are being used in different condition. In the same condition, all cannot be applied on. So for that sake, let's discuss further, such as the mean is the only measure of central tendency where the sum of the deviation of each value from the mean is always zero. So from the data set, the mean will be calculated and it will come out zero as well. Now, while on the other hand, the main disadvantage of mean is its susceptibility to the influence of outliers. So the indifferent figure cannot be accepted in the mean because it's going to disturb the mean value. As the data becomes skewed, the mean lost its ability to provide the best central location for the data because the skewed data is dragging it away from the typical value. So because of the outlier, it is going to disturb the actual mean value. So that will be a disturbed value which is not going to accept it when it comes to the mean. So the mean always get affected by the outliers. Now further, when it comes to the medians, the median is less affected by outlier and skewed data because median has some property that it makes a better option than the mean as a measure of central tendency. So in the median, we always try to see the middle value and we always locate toward the median position. In the data series, if you find some value is median value, it will be considered as a median of that particular data set. As long as the even data set is concerned and the odd data set is being concerned, both will have their designated way to resolve it. Now further, the mode has advantage over the median and the mean, and it can be found for both numerical and the categorical non-numerical. So the mode will be having the advantage over median for numerical as well as for the non-numerical data. So mode can be calculated for the numerical values, numerical data set, as well as for the non-numerical data set. Now the mode has its limitations too. So limitations concern, let's discuss, in some distributions the mode may not reflect the center of the distribution because it vary well. Now the presence of more than one mode can limit the ability of the mode in describing the center or the typical value of the distribution because a single value cannot be identified to describe the center. So in the mode, we are usually taking the value which is having a more maximum iteration, which is being repetitively coming. Now in the mode could be the possibility there are mode, there may be no mode. Now in some cases, particularly where the data are continuous, so when the data is in the continuous, the distribution may have no mode at all. So it is depending upon the data set, what sort of data we have. In the continuous series, we may not have the mode. And that actually depending upon what set of data is being available, then only the mode will be calculated on. While in such cases, it may be better to consider only the median or mean, or group the data into appropriate interval and find the mode model class. So the mean, mode and the median all are having their own advantages, and they have the categories where actually the data, that particular central tendency category will be applied on. Mean have their own advantages, the median have their own advantages, and the mode also have their own advantages. And at what condition of data set the value will be, the category of central tendency would be applied on, that will always be considered on, and thereby it is only applied. Now, in order to understand the central tendency better, we will take up a one question. So the practice question is that, let's say there are 5 houses on a hill by the beach, and the prices of the house is being given. So the data set for the house prices is somewhat like 20 lakh, 5 lakh, 3 lakh, 1 lakh and 1 lakh. So the number of the series in the data set is 5. And in that sake, for this practice question, we have to calculate mean, mode and the median. Now let's discuss the solution of the problem. Now this we have given in the question itself, that there are 5 observed value for the house price. Now first we have to calculate the mean. So for the mean, the formula states that observed values divided by the sample size. And this question, the observed values are 5, and if we sum up all the house prices, which is the observed value, so the sum up would be 30 lakh. And the sample size here is 5. So what we do, we just simply divide 30 lakh by 5. So we'll be able to get 6 lakh. So 6 lakh would be the mean for this given house prices data series. Now the next is the median. Median is what? Median is middle value of the rank data. And since the data given is in the odd series, so we'll easily take up 3 lakh as a median, because before the 3 lakh rupees, first and second value is the 50%, and fourth and the fifth value is again the 50%. So the middle is the 3 lakh, and we can say the median for this particular house prices is 3 lakh rupees. Now the next is the mode. So for the mode is the most frequent value, or we can say the value which have the maximum iteration. And in this given data set of house prices, the maximum iteration which is being taking place is the 1 lakh rupees, which actually repeated twice. So we can concretely say that 1 lakh rupees is the mode for this particular problem. So this is how we have to calculate the mean, median and mode for the given data set. And the similar can be solved with the help of examples. These are the references used for conducting this session. And in the last, I would like to thank you everyone for listening it well. Thank you very much.